Hello, my little witchlings, and thank you for joining me today. Unfortunately, today's topic is a little bit of a touchy one, but it's close to my heart. Let's talk biology, specifically how someone is born trans. Before we get started, I would like to give you a little warning. Most people use the science to police other people's identities. They act as gatekeepers to transness. That's not how we should go about this. That's not what science is meant to be about. Remember, only you decide your identity. However you feel is valid. Only you decide what makes you comfortable with who you are and where you are. It should go without saying, but the only violations to that rule would be if it harms another person or yourself. Of course, self-harm should generally be defined by the individual rather than society. That being said, we now need to know a little bit about embryonic and fetal development within our species. Of course, we'll only be discussing the highlights relevant to this topic, but I do recommend that you go and check it out, because if you have kids in the future, you may want to know. Around week 5, the embryo begins developing the central nervous system of this new life, the brain and spinal cord. In the next week, the brain will begin to differentiate into the 5 parts: the cerebellum, the hypothalamus, the cerebrum, pituitary gland, and brainstem. During weeks 7 through 8, the brain continues to grow and change. Throughout weeks 9 and 10, the fetus will begin to produce its own sex hormones. At week 11, the genitals may be discernible, but that's not always the case. If the gonads differentiated into testes, these will descend from the lower abdomen down into the scrotum over the next few weeks. Now that we know a little bit about the development, we can begin to break it down in certain areas. Current studies show that individuals assigned male at birth have a repetitive genetic code for the androgen receptor NR3C4. This is merely one of the ways that an individual can be androgen insensitive, and it's likely that we'll find more ways in the future. However, this insensitivity can cause insufficient masculinization in the somatosensory and motor cortices of the brain. In individuals assigned female at birth, the loss of an allele distribution pattern, CYP17T-34C, seems to be the cause. This deletion would result in insensitivity to pregnenolone and progesterone. This is unlikely to be the complete explanation behind why some people do or do not identify with the gender they are assigned at birth. However, in children, teens, and young adults, it can be an enormous relief to identify where nature has taken another branch and created a unique individual, specifically you. Thank you for joining me. Stay safe, my little witchlings, and know that you are incredible today and every day. If you'd like a shirt like the one I'm wearing now, you can check out Rock and Custom Dyes by Marcella or my Patreon page. We have wonderful tie-dye perks to offer you. Bye!